action coming in after the House Judiciary Committee put the squeeze on AG Bill Barr. Ranking member Doug Collins writing this piece. FoxNews.com. Here's the headline. By voting to hold Barr in contempt, Dems defy logic and precedent. Congressman Collins out of Georgia is our headliner. Sir, how you doing? And good morning to you.
Well, good morning. It's good to be with
you. Defying logic and precedent. Start there.
Well, number one, they asked the attorney general to do something that he legally cannot do. Their subpoena asked for grand jury information. They can't get around it. If you look at the subpoena, there's no exceptions. Although they want to tell you that, they tried to tell that in the committee yesterday. The chairman tried to say that they weren't trying to get that. That's not true. The subpoena is asking for something he can't do, number one. Number two is the precedent here is we're less than 40 days, and that's a generous counting of when they asked for documents and when they're actually heading and held the contempt hearing yesterday. As you just made a mention just a few minutes ago, it was over a year, 400 plus days between this time and contempt for Eric Holder, in which a lot of accommodations were done. The Democrats have just run roughshod over accommodations because they're wanting to get at the bottom line to paint Bill Barr as a bad person.
The bottom line is that Bill Barr was basically upholding the law, and he did not have to release any of that report whatsoever. He could have not released an unredacted report or a redacted report either way. So how is it that they're now holding him in contempt for upholding the law, and when is it that it goes to a full House vote?
Well, that's the great question right now is how can you hold the gentleman in contempt for actually doing what the law says, but actually he gave more than what the law actually required for him to say. What is also disturbing is the chairman of the committee, who has access to go see the even less redacted report, which is 99% less redacted, has chose not even to do that, to not even take an accommodation that he's been offered. When they bring it to the House floor, they're going to have to still answer these questions on why they're trying to rush it. But the bottom line, they're rushing it is because they're trying to paint Bill Barr as someone bad, because they don't like the results of the Mueller report, so they have to have someone who did something improper or didn't put it out properly. And this is sad because the chairman of the committee actually said yesterday that the subpoena is just simply to start dialogue. That's any attorney in this country would have laughed at that. That is not what a subpoena is for. A subpoena is actually to produce something that is a legal and binding agreement.
Well, speaking of contempt, I want to take you back to 2012. Jerry Nadler tweeted this, just joined the walkout of the House chamber to protest the shameful politically motivated GOP vote holding AG Holder in contempt. Democrats would argue it's not apples to apples. What would you argue?
I would argue that they don't want that tweet to show back up, and unfortunately it did. It would have been nice if he had been such an outrage yesterday that he wouldn't have went through with what he had planned then. It is different. And when you look at an oversight investigation of a process that the Attorney General and the Department of Justice was running, basically a gun smuggling operation that ended up in the death of an American in that process, and this is a process in which they're holding an Attorney General in contempt for basically following the law. Let's just be very clear. Yesterday in the hearing, it came out, the curtain was pulled back when Hank Johnson from Georgia basically said two things. Number one, he said, how can you impeach if we don't get the documents? That shows their true intent. And then number two, he said, we can't wait 400 days. That tells me that this is all about rushing to a judgment because they're desperate to paint the president as done something wrong. And the way they do that is by painting the attorney general who delivered Bob Mueller's message that there was no collusion and no charge of obstruction. They're painting him as bad.
If they're not happy with the Mueller report, why not hold Mueller in contempt? And why not delay that vote until Mueller actually testifies? And then the question is he going to testify on May 15th? Republicans yesterday had urged Nadler to delay the vote until they heard from Mueller, you included. They decided not to.
Well, I encouraged him to delay the vote because what he was doing was just too fast and wrong. And it's really what he did yesterday. The chairman and the Democrats did yesterday was actually hurt committee jurisdiction on the Hill. What they did by rushing to do this is they took basically our power of subpoena and contempt and they made a mockery of it. And then when they go to court and it's not upheld, when they did not lay the proper foundation, then for any committee going forward, whether it be Republican or Democrat led, they are the ones that have caused basically the constitutional crisis that the speaker likes to throw around and others. There's no constitutional crisis here except the one that the chairman's creating on his own by rushing something forward that undercuts the oversight authority of us.
Sir, I've got a minute, three quick questions. Does Bob Mueller testify next Wednesday, the 15th of May, yes or no?
No.
He does not.
We've not heard that. I mean, that was thrown out by a congressman who then later retracted it on a tweet. We've not got any notice, and they would have had to notify that hearing already.
So maybe yes, maybe no, or is it a flat out no?
I would say it's probably a no.
Okay.
Flat out no.
There's this question about holding Mueller in contempt. Is that even possible?
Not at this point,
okay.
No.
On the IG report, how do you believe this story changes once we see it?
Now you've hit the real story. This is why they're trying to paint Bill Barr as well. When the IG report comes back about the FISA abuse and how this actually got started, they know that the attorney general has said, I'm committed to actually finding out how we got into this mess. That's why the Democrats are painting him as someone not telling the truth and not being cooperative, because when this comes out, they're going to have to deal with the fact of what I've talked about and many others, of the corrupt cabal of Comey and Strzok and Page and how this actually got started. And that's what they're afraid of with Bill Barr.
Okay. Sir, thank you for your time. Doug Collins, more to discuss. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good to see you.